BBCJ Jones Nation, I want you to listen to this.
Your voice, your vote.
Ephesians 6:12 reads,
"For our struggle is not against flesh and blood, but against the rulers, against the authorities, against the powers of this dark world, and against the spiritual forces of evil in the heavenly realms."
Your voice, your vote.
Remember,
vote for the person who is best for the job.
Family and friends, we're days away from the 2016 United States presidential election, and I want you to remain calm and peaceful. Live in the studio is my good friend and mentor, Dr. Kenneth Hill, to share a very powerful word and to pray us up. All inside the Big Brother CJ radio broadcast. Come on, Dr. Hill.
Hello again, Big Brother CJ. Thank you, thank you, thank you for inviting me to join you in the studio once again. It is an extreme pleasure for me to be with you and to talk with you and to pray with you and to be with your audience as well. Big Brother CJ, these are trying times. As the Bible would say, they're times that try men's souls. We've got an election that's coming up that is probably one of the most historic elections in the life of this great nation. We've watched all sorts of things go on between the candidates that have made us ill. They've turned our stomachs. We've seen candidates, grown people, mature people, acting as if they are not grown nor mature. Now, without getting too explicit or going overboard, just let me say this. God is not surprised by the shenanigans, by the actions, by the various things that political partisans do or that candidates do. God is not shocked by any of these things. He's watched it all down through history, and he knows exactly what's going on. He knows the end from the beginning. And so he tells us, don't let your heart be troubled. Don't let your heart fear. So while I'm with you and with all of our friends, I want to ask for each of us to just take some time and to pause as we pray, as I've been praying. And I want to pray again for us to unite together and let the healing of America begin both before and after the election. I know that God is in control and His will be done. And we are not to stand in God's way. However, I like to be doing what God would have me to be doing. And I'm sure everyone that's listening wants to do that as well. So whatever you're doing, as a CJ Jones Nation, let's gather together and let's pause and let's pray for this election and for our nation. Let's pray. Gracious Heavenly Father, maker of heaven and earth, our wonderful Lord, we come before your presence in this, the very throne room, in the name and through the blood of Jesus Christ, asking you to receive our thanks, our praise, and our adoration, for you, Lord, alone are worthy of those things from us. Lord, we're coming at this very moment with a heavy heart, one that is near the breaking point for many of us who are praying just now, because our nation needs your touch. Our nation needs your leadership. Our nation needs you to be in charge, Heavenly Father. And so we ask you to begin by working in my heart. I ask you, Lord, to start with me and then work in the heart and life of Big Brother CJ and all of the people that are associated with this fine work that he does. And then I would ask you, Lord, to touch the hearts and work in the hearts and lives of those who listen and participate in the CJ Jones Nation, wherever they happen to be. And Father, I would present us to you, asking you by your grace to exchange any anxiety, any fear, any concern about the election, about the future of our nation, about our own futures, that you would take that anxiety, remove it from us, far from us, and give us your peace. Lord, I know that you have promised that those who will follow Jesus Christ will have complete, perfect peace. And so we ask for that, thanking you for it ahead of time, knowing that you're giving it to us. Now, Father, I pray that you would bring us the leadership that we need in this nation, politically, spiritually, in all things, and that you would not only guide us, but as you provide for us as we move forward, that you would use us for your honor and glory, and then empower us, each one, to be that person of peace, tranquility, and love that you would want us to be, that we might affect others for good in all things. We love you. We praise your holy name. We give you thanks in the name that's above all names, the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and our Savior and our soon coming King. Amen and amen.
I am a Christian. Do you know what that means? Means I'm far from perfect, simply redeemed. I was bought with a purpose, purchased by love. It's not a form of religion, it's a gift from above. I am not perfect.
His life.